me this morning here in the studio from Tower Resources. I'm joined by Jeremy Asher. Jeremy, good morning.
Good morning.
Look, firstly, I want to get your thoughts here on this dramatic drop in the oil price. What's your insight? What's your reaction?
Well, the interesting thing is that the Saudis last week in the OPEC meeting were trying to put together a consensus to cut output and shore up prices. They were rebuffed by the Russians, who wanted to take more of a wait-and-see approach to see what actually happens to demand over the next few months. And as a result, they turned on a dime over the weekend and decided that instead they're going to raise output and cut prices with the objective of ensuring that no one else gains market share at their expense and so forth. I think it's quite an impetuous decision, but over the last couple of years, we've gotten used to relatively impetuous decisions. And it's a strategy that failed in the past, so I don't know how long it will last, but in the meantime, it certainly had a dramatic effect, and it's made a statement, which might have been the objective.
Does this change the plan for you at all, or the attractiveness, if you like, of your Cameroon project?
Well, our project economics are very robust, and as I explained last year, our economics, which we've looked at all the way down to $40 a barrel and below, still look good even at those prices. In fact, in our September 2019 investor presentation, which is still available for download on our website, I showed some specifically a sensitivity of the economics to a $40 flat Brent price. Now, the prompt price right now is, last time I looked, it was around $36 a barrel. Mm-hmm. But the forward prices in 2022, 2023, which what matter to us, are still well above $40 a barrel. And I think that one of the attractions of our project has always been that it's so robust economically to even quite low oil prices. I mean, this is low cost production. That's why it's attractive to develop. So at the moment, I've seen no reason why this should hold us back. And I did speak to our partners in Australia already this morning, and they also, as of this morning, are still planning to go ahead as normal. So I hope that, in fact, our project will be even more of a standout in circumstances where more marginal projects obviously will have to, you know, take a good hard look at themselves.
Just while we're on the subject of wider headwinds in the marketplace and your project here in Cameroon, what about coronavirus? Are you expecting that to slow you down at all?
It's interesting. We have been giving thought over the last month to coronavirus related risks, of course. Our long lead items are already in Douala in Cameroon, as investors know, and so we don't face a problem in terms of disruption to shipping lines or anything like that. There are some short lead items that still we need to bring in, like bunkers, for example, or drilling mud, but these are all sourced very locally, so we don't expect that to be affected by coronavirus. It's just the usual short lead times on getting those kind of things delivered. In terms of personnel, I think that we're actually in pretty good shape, because unlike some companies where everyone's all in an office together, we've always been working distributed. And so our people are in Cameroon and different offices in the UK and Ireland. We're used to working via video conference on Zoom. That's how we've been doing things for years. So the likelihood of us all getting sick all at the same time is quite low. And in particular, I think there's plenty of us capable of project managing things if even if one or two of us are laid low for a couple of weeks.
And onto your announcement this morning, the fundraise here, £500,000. Not a brilliant time to be issuing more shares.
Well, indeed. One of the things that we were seeing last week was the coronavirus impact on the markets and people's confidence. And so it wasn't an easy time, but we did think it was prudent to go and give ourselves a little more cash cushion as we get these well financing completed. And at the same time, we were facing some of these questions from investors. But I think that the fact that we were able to get this placing done last week, and even today with the oil price news, when I last looked, our shares were trading right around the placing price. It goes to underscore the fact that even though the markets are obviously very nervous at the moment, our project economics are extremely good and our value proposition to investors remains extremely good.
And when are you expecting the farm out to complete?
We set a date of April 15th, and that was really my target date because I want to keep everyone focused on getting documentation done in time. But I still think that's achievable. I hope that that's what we'll do.
And as far as some of the ins and outs of this agreement, the Australian firm, they'll get what, 24.5% interest?
They get 24.5% in return for $7.5 million. That's subject to a overriding royalty interest in our favour, which is a reflection of the fact that some of the costs that we incurred putting this together don't even form part of the back costs. They're not recoverable, but it's as a result of those costs that we have the attractive fiscal terms that we have in the agreement. So that's a good deal, I think, for both parties.
And have you set a date for when you'd like to be drilling?
We've geared up so that we could start drilling as early as the end of June, but this very much depends on the rig schedule as well, and so we'll have to see, but obviously we want to be drilling as soon as we can.
And still having discussions with other potential farminees as well?
Yes, and we do hope that we'll bring in another partner, bring some more capital from that source.
So despite some of the challenges out there at the moment, which we've already discussed, how are you feeling generally?
Well, I'm feeling quite good about Tower, but the trouble is that we don't live in a bubble, and you know the world is a worrying place at the moment. Nevertheless, I think when things are difficult, you know, one needs to find some things to focus on that are positive and exciting and still looking good, and happily Tower is one of them.
Jeremy, good to see you. Thank you.
Thanks.